بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is a lecture, an introduction to translation. It's introduction to translation in which in this lecture we are going to introduce a number of semantic aspects necessary for learning translation. Here we have the types of meaning. There are three main types of meaning: the denotative meaning, the connotative meaning, and the contextual meaning. Identifying each of these is very necessary for the process of translation. The denotative meaning is the meaning you find in a dictionary. Like, for example, if you look for the meaning of the word mother, you will find a female, parent, or om in Arabic. The connotative meaning is the meaning you don't find in a dictionary, but people agree upon. For example, if you take the same word, mother, and ask anybody, what does it bring to your mind? Usually it brings a kind person, a nice or a loving or a responsible person, probably the cook or the nurse, etc. Contextual meaning is the meaning you find in a context depending on what is before or what is after the word. For example, when you say Zayd's mother, Umm Zayd, or Umm 44, or it means centipede, Umm al-Qura, Mecca, bi Umm Ainihi, with his own eyes. Look at the word Umm here. They have different meanings according to the words that come before them. Yani, Umm Zayd here, Umm is the mother of Zayd. When I talk about Umm 44, this is the name of a creature. It is not, let us say, a human being. So we have to go and check the exact equivalent for this word. When we talk about Umm al-Qura here, it's a city. It's not a human being again. When I say bi Umm Ainihi here, bi Umm Ainihi, again, it's not a woman. Where it is an idiom used by Arabs to mean with his own eyes. Now, when we come to the components of meaning, the first component is the sign, which is the linguistic element. Yani when, for example, rose, il R-O-S-E, or jury in Arabic, like jim, waw, ra, ya. The other component is the referential, which is the object in a real word, the flower itself, not the letters, يعني the element, the material. The last component is the interpretant. What does it bring to your mind when I say flower? What does it bring to your mind? How people interpret the sign, يعني beautiful, innocent, passionate, with nice smell. When I say rose, these elements come to your mind. Okay, now collocation is another important semantic element in translation. Collocation is the company words key. For example, when I say a flock of bird is in Arabic sir min al-tuyur, a school of fish majmu'a min al-asmar, a herd of sheep qati' min al-ghanam. When we look at the words flock, school, or herd, actually they have the same meaning. This is to say a group of animals. Okay, so but usually with birds we use a flock, with fish we use a school, with sheep we use herd. This is a feature of language which exists in Arabic as well. So with al-tuyur we use sirb, with al-asmak we use majmu'a, with al-ghanam we use qati'. Now this characteristic applies not only to nouns, it also applies to verbs, to prepositions, etc. Now, these meanings have shades. Usually meanings have shades. The shades of meaning are additional meanings which are added to the denotative meaning of a lexical item. They differentiate between synonyms. For example, when I say he is not rich, and he is poor. Actually, not rich and poor, they are related in meaning. We can say they are synonyms. But if you look exactly at these two synonyms, you will find that there are certain differences. When I say not rich, he has some money, but not a lot. Whereas when I say he is poor, this means that he doesn't have any money. So they are synonymous, yes, but they are not exactly the same. These shades of meanings are essential in a translation. They change your translation a great deal. Thank you.